This makeup was done years ago for the monkeys. I was worried when I saw the VHS again that it would look ridiculous and old-fashioned, you know, and quite naff. It's not true. It looks great, still.
Would you like a drink of something? Tea, coffee, juice?
I'd love a glass of water.
No! That's mine.
All right, don't sweat it. I'll suck them in. I'll come straight to the point.
Where does the church stand on the matter of evolution?
Monkeys were created by God to entertain us. That's all we know, Rick.
But surely...
That's all we know, Rick!
Yeah. Sure, Padre. I think I understand.
Come on, Liz.
Mind how you go, Rick. Mind how you go.
It worsens. The Padre, my friend and colleague, is now an ape. Who was next? Would it get me? I really hoped it wouldn't. And what was it, anyway? So many questions. Why Liz? Why the Padre? Why Sanchez? Why not Reed? Why not me? This hospital was turning into a jungle.
And everyone was acting like monkeys.
Terry, run a J over the seat. I think Liz has left a souvenir.
Emergency in surgery. Emergency in surgery.
Not my fault, monkey bastard hands.
It wasn't difficult for me to get into character. I mean, I know the beast in me. I've been drunk with him for 15 years. So it was home from home, you might say.
Both Todd and I were wild at the time. I mean, we were behaving like flipping Romans. We were like animals. And I looked in the mirror one day, excuse me, and I said, "You're not a man, Dean. You're an ape."
I've stood in Dean's front room and watched him make a lot of love. Let's just say that.
I'm afraid, Rick. I'm afraid of what I'm becoming. Yeah, that's me. Well, this is unmanageable. I used to have the best head in the hospital. And I'm starting to get some pretty primal urges.
I didn't want to say, but when I went into surgery this morning, you were waving your bits out the window.
I don't even know I'm doing it. I thought I was helping attach a drip. I went to the Padre to confess. Ended up washing my ass in the font.
Liz is throwing her own poo as a way of getting attention.
If I get too far gone, Rick, you know what to do.
Yeah. Well, you hang on in there, bud. You hang on in there for Rick.
My bonds having been knocked, I fell into a strange fantastical dream, rich in imaginative imagery. I found myself alone in a primitive land where phantasms, spelt with a PH, not an F, abounded. I turned one way, then the other, then back, then forward. Then I saw myself as a monkey. When I came to, my head felt like a plum without the pip. Apparently I'd been asleep for a month, which is ages. Reed told me everything. How the monkeys now ruled Darkplace. How they'd taken over.
They've taken over.
Oh, no. Oh, Jesus. They've taken over. They've taken over.
I know.
Why's Liz here?
The clan rejected her. She'd been mauled when I found her. The brutes.
What are we going to do, Reid?
Blow me if I know. God, my throat is parched. I'd best have a sip of water. Look, Dag, maybe we shouldn't do anything.
What do you mean?
I mean, this hospital's running pretty well, despite all this.
What do you mean?
No one takes days off anymore, everyone's grooming each other, and the doctors are literally working for peanuts. Within a year, our financial problems will be history, old news. We'll be able to build that children's wing. Think about it, Rick. The Darkplace Dagless Kiddie Wing. It's what we've always dreamed about.
Not this way, Reid. It's barbaric. I want that kiddie wing just as much as you do. But right now, most of those kids are chimps, and that's my priority.
You're a fool! You're a fool to walk away from this! You're a fool! 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 You're a flipping fool! You're a fool!
Bad with you two like a glass of water.
I don't even have time to drink this water, Umber.
I'll grab a coffee instead of the water.
Would you like a drink of something?
I don't even have time to drink this water, Umber.
It's the water. The water. The water. The water. The water. The water.
I still haven't had a glass of water. Wait a minute, it is the water.
Don't drink that. Look, it's bright green.
Thank God I only took a tiny sip.
Someone or something has been tampering with our water supply. I'm going to the water store. I have a hunch that whoever or whatever he or she or it is will be in there.
Right, I'll stay here and try and recuperate as fast as I can.
2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yeah, I shot Duncan. Hang tight.
The reason Reid survives is that I only take a tiny sip. There's that line, thank God I only took a tiny sip. And if you take a tiny sip of this, you're all right.
I know writers who use subtext and they're all cowards. OK? What I was asking in that scene is, what if politicians continue to pay doctors peanuts? Could they literally turn into monkeys? And no one's asked that before.